Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 5.5, Problem 6. This is Section 5.5, Problem number 6. It asks us to compute 8 permutation 8 and 8 combination 8. So, for 8 permutation 8, again, remember the permutation formula, n permutation r equals n factorial over, in parentheses, n minus r factorial. Now, I always say the larger number is the n and the smaller number is the r. Well, they're both the same, so one 8 is for n, the other 8 is for r. That one you can't really get mixed up with. So, on top, n factorial will be 8 factorial. In the denominator, n minus r will be 8 minus 8 factorial. So you're going to have 8 factorial over 8 minus 8 is 0 factorial. So it's not 0. Remember, 0 factorial is defined to be 1. So in the bottom, you'll have 1, and in the top, it'll be 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And ordinarily, when we do these, there's some amount of stuff that will cancel in the top and the bottom, but nothing really cancels. You just have to multiply that all out. And if you multiply it out, the answer comes out to 40,320. You multiply 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, that answer is 40,320. So if you have 8 things to choose from, there's over 40,000 different ways you can choose all 8 of them when you have no repeats and the order matters. Like if you arrange them in different orders, it counts as a different answer. Now, the combination one will be easier, you'll see. Let's do 8 combination 8, and it's going to be not nearly as big as the 40,000 answer we got for the permutation. So the combination formula, n combination r equals n factorial in the numerator over n minus r factorial in the denominator times r factorial in front of the parentheses. So again, they're both 8, so which one is n, which one is r, it doesn't really matter. I mean, it's supposed to be that the bigger value is the n and the smaller is the r. But when they're both the same, you know, they can put them in either spot. So n factorial is 8 factorial for the numerator. In the denominator, the r factorial will be 8 factorial. And then in the parentheses, n minus r will be 8 minus 8 factorial. So do your work in parentheses first to leave the 8 factorial in the numerator. There's an 8 factorial in the denominator, times 8 minus 8 is 0 factorial. Now, remember, 0 factorial is defined to be 1. So I can really have 8 factorial in the top over 8 factorial times 1 in the denominator. So it winds up being 8 factorial over 8 factorial, which you could multiply out and reduce it, but I know it's going to reduce to 1. It's going to be 40,320 over 40,320. We don't have to multiply it out. It's the same value over itself. It must reduce to 1. Now, that brings up a cool shortcut. Whenever the two numbers match for combination, the answer will be 1. Whatever the number is, as long as it's the same, the first number and the second number, the answer is 1. That's not the case for permutation, as you can see. But for combination, it is. So let's say 85 combination 85. I know the answer is 1 because it's the same number for both N and R.